Hello everyone. In my previous videos, I had told you how to schedule a meeting, how to join the meeting, how to enable the waiting room, the lobby of the Teams app, then how to mark the attendance, and a few things which you need to keep in mind while making your team. So now in this video, I'll be telling you about the assignments. So let us go to our Teams app. I go to the Teams. I go to all my teams. So these are the teams that I had made. Let me take you to my class wherein I have posted a few assignments. So this is the current class that I have. I go to the assignments here. If you see the assignments, so these are the few assignments that I have asked my students to submit. One, the first assignment, 32 students have submitted out of 35. Second one, 30 have submitted out of 35. Fourth one, third, fourth. So these are the assignments. This is the latest assignment which I submitted yesterday. And you can see that which is a due date, like the last assignment, the due date is 17th of April. Six students have already submitted and three I have checked and returned. Now, the good thing about this is that if I go on to grades, then I get my complete follow-up at one glance. So if I click on these grades, you can see that Karan Arora, the first child, he has just seen the assignment. These three assignments was given to me, which he has returned. But this assignment has not even been checked by, not even been seen by him. If I see for this child, the five assignments have been done, but this last assignment has not been submitted as yet. If I take this child, these two assignments were given, but these assignments are not given. So at a glance, while taking the glance, I can just quickly go on to these grades and I can get my follow-up at a glance. There is no need to note down that which child has given me the work or which child has not given me the work. Maybe I can see here, like this one. For this child, he has given me this assignment. I have checked and returned. I have checked and returned. I have checked and returned. These are the two assignments submitted newly, turned in. So I am still left with checking of these. So it's very convenient for me to see at a glance that what all is my pending work. Going through this, this is something very, very convenient for us. The hassle of maintaining the record and the follow-up, we are saved with that. And a complete detailed work can be seen over here. Now, let me show you how do we assign the work. I go back to my teams. I go to all my teams. So I want to assign the work to this. So this was the team I had created yesterday, the demo team. So I'll be assigning the work here to the Mathematics 10. So how do I do that? I go to assignments. Okay. And you can see this create button here. Can you see here the create button? I click on this create and I go on to this assignment. Now, to create an assignment, I want to give it to Mathematics 10. So I click on Mathematics 10 and I go to the next. Right? This is the assignment that has opened up. Now I enter the assignment. Let us say I'm entering linear equations in two variables. Supposing I want to give it this as assignment. Okay, this is the assignment. Assignment one, I can number it as this is the assignment one. And what is the name of the chapter? It is linear equations in two variables. Then the instructions, complete all questions and upload the PDF. Now, this is very important because I don't want the images to be posted. I just want the assignment resources. I have a printed assignment. I have already written the assignment. So I add to the resources. What is assignment? So I add it over here. Now, from where do I need to find out the resources? I can take out something from the internet or I can take out from my upload from this device. I have it in my saved on my system. So I'll upload from this device. From where do I want it? I'll take it from the desktop. So I go to the desktop here. On the desktop, let me see what all is there. So I'll take up this assignment, linear equations. You can see it here. I click on this. I go to open and the assignment is this green line. The moment it's filled up. There you are. This is done. done. So I'll click on this done and the assignment gets added here. You can see this assignment has been added. Now, assigned to mathematics class 10th, all students. I could have given it to few students also. If maybe there is some assignment for the gifted students or some assignment for the weak students, so I can decide which all students I want to send the assignment to, and it's going to go only to them. The due date today is 14th April. I need to give at least 2 to 3 days to the students. So let me give the date as 17th. So I go to the calendar button here and I assign the date of 17th. So 17th April till that, till 11:59 p.m. it's going to accept the assignments. If I want to stop that after that, I don't want any child to be giving the assignment, then I have to edit it and give a date that the it should close and on this particular date. Otherwise, it will keep on taking the assignment and it will write that it is late by 10 days, or it's late by 2 days, it is late by 3 days, and so on. Once all this is done, I can either save it and give it later on, or if I want to assign it right now, so I just click on this assign, and the assignment will be going to the students. You will see the notification that the notification is going to go to Mathematics 10th. Let me see what kind of notification the students get. So here, if you see, I go to the Teams and I see Mathematics 10th, and I get a notification, assignments mentioned Mathematics 10th in general, and I have this assignment. So children now can view this assignment. They click here, okay, and I can, this is how I can see the work that nobody has sent in the work. Now I am still waiting for some child to post in the work. In the meantime, if the student sees the work, he'll have to add the file, and on adding the file, he will have to, once it's added, I will get a notification here, turned in. So let me see if the child is able to add on this file. Let me see if somebody has turned in. So I can see here Abhyuday Gandhi and Shriyan Datta. These are two students who've sent in their work. So I want to check this work now. Up till now, what was the procedure that we were doing? I used to click on this, and the work used to be reflected here. Now, what the best I could do was that I can write here good work after seeing the work of the child. I can just scroll it down that how the work has been done. And after seeing this work, I can give a comment. I can give a feedback that the work is good or work is bad. Or else what I could have done, I used to download this. I used to click here, download the assignment. Then I used to see it in the downloads, open it up there, check it, and then return it individually through the chat. Now, what if all this happens in one go without downloading it? So this is the beauty of this Microsoft Teams. How do we do that? Okay, now let me close this and I'll show you the complete procedure, how it is to be done. So I go to the Teams once again. I am looking in for this team. So I click on this team here, and you can see here in the right, these three dots. Can you see here these three dots, these small three dots? Click on them and you go to open in SharePoint. Okay, I click on this, open in SharePoint. Now the moment I click on this, this Mathematics 10th opens in SharePoint, and you can see on the left side. Now this SharePoint is what? It is just like your drive. It is the Google Drive that you are using. It's just like your drive. Everything is here in a very arranged manner. What I do is, I want to open this in SharePoint means that I have opened it in Drive now. Now go to the left side. Left side you see documents, shared with us, notebook, pages, site contents. So I go to site contents and I click here. Now, once I have clicked here, there are number of things that you can see. There are class files, there are documents, there are form templates, site assets, student work, style library, and site pages. What I need is the student work. So I'll click on this student's work. And once I have got the student work, and you sync this folder. Okay, you can see here the sync written here. After clicking on student's work, I sync this folder. Now this is saying that it is getting ready to sync. And you are now syncing Mathematics 10th. You can edit files in Mathematics 10th student work. Click here to view your files. So that means it has started syncing, the work is being done. Now, once I've done this, the file is saved now. The file is saved now. Where is it? How do I go and access this file? I again minimize my complete screen. I minimize everything and I go to this PC, I could have directly gone to the place. So here you see there is one folder that is made. This is new thing that has come up now. This is the DAV Public School Sector 14 Gurgaon. This is the folder of the drive where all my team work will go. So I click here and you can see there are three folders. So I need the folder of Mathematics 10 students work, student work. So I click here and I go to the submitted files. Okay, I go on to the submitted files and I can see the work, all my students that I had taken yesterday, their work is here. I know Abhyuday Gandhi and Shriyan Datta have posted the work. So let me open up the work of Abhyuday Gandhi and see how the work is. So I just click here. I get this assignment. I open it. This is version one. I open it once again and the PDF can be seen. Now I just open this PDF. It is downloading in the system. It is not downloaded any other downloads or anywhere. I need to check here. It is being downloaded. It will take a few seconds to download. The moment it is downloaded, it can either open in your Microsoft Edge or it can open in this Microsoft PDF Acrobat Reader DC, whichever app you are using for the checking work. I go to the comment section and I start checking the work. This is the first question. I am adding the equations. I am subtracting the equations. I get the two equations. Their answers are coming. The correct, this is for what value of k, then this is also correct. The value of k is 6, k is equal to 6, this is correct. And then I can also find out another set of values. This is k is equal to, this is not clear, so you are right here, this is not clear. I'll ask the child to resend this pic, but I can see it is k square is equal to 36, so k is equal to plus minus 6. So the common value is k is equal to 6. So then I go ahead. So this is how I can check the work. I'll just quickly scroll down and show it to you how the work is being done. The values of x and here it is correct. Then I go on to the next thing. K is equal to minus 1. This is also correct. This is the question that is there. I get the equations and I get the values of x and y. The answer statement is also there. That's also written correctly. So that means the work is being done well. I am not going to go through the complete assignment. Let me go to the end and show it to you how it is being done. So the complete assignment, once it is checked, the graph work is done. The scale is correct. I am marking the arrows as also done here. Common solution is also right here. It's the only common solution that is also. So whatever points I need in the graph, they are all there. The lines are parallel, area of the trapezium has been found out. This is not the correct thing that has been done. Area of the trapezium is equal to, I'll make a small change here. It is equal to, if I mark this as point A, B, C, and let's say D, E. So area of the trapezium will be equal to, area will be equal to A, B, C minus area of D, B, C, which comes out to be half into 6 into 3 minus half into 2 into 1, which comes out to be as 9 minus 1, so 8 square units. So this is the incorrect thing. I have corrected it and rest all is, let's say if it is correct. I'll write here the work is done well. I'll give a remark and the work is done. After this, I'm just going to save it. Save as. By default, wherever it was there, this is the place it was. Abhyuday Gandhi assignment, it is going to win version 1. I'll click on this and it will be saved as linear equations assignment. I'll save it. Now, this assignment is already there. You want to replace it? Yes, I want to replace it by the correct, the checked assignment. So I'll click on yes. Once this is done, I'll just close it. I'll close it here. And now let me see if this work is done. See, you can see this green tick, that means it has been synced. If this green tick is not there, that means it will take some time to sync. I go on to my teams here. I go to the assignments. I haven't returned anything. I click here. Abhyuday's work I have checked. So I click here. I give the feedback. Good work. You can see this checked assignment has already been put here. So I'll just write good work. And I will return it. So now Abhyuday receives the work. The checked work has gone to him. I have not downloaded it anywhere or I have not uploaded anything. The work that has gone to him after checking is the corrected work. You can see all my remarks, whatever I have written, they are all, everything is reflecting here. Can you see the last change that I had done? I'll show it to you, whatever I had written. See here, the assignment work that I had given them, it is all shown here. So the correction work, what I am sending to the child, that all reflects and my work is done. So I close it and I can go to the grades and see that what was the work that is done. I know now these are the students. This was one assignment. Shriyan has turned in. I am still to check his work. And Abhyuday's work I have returned. So this is so simple to work in the teams. I do not need to send any links. I do not need to ask for any links from the folders. I do not need to download the assignments. I do not need to upload the assignments to the students anymore. Directly, everything that I am getting is checked there, returned there, and I can get the complete detailed analysis that who all has done the work and who all have not. So I hope this is going to be a good experience for you. Do let me know if there's any doubt. I'm always there to help you out. Thank you so much.